It's the Newlywed Game. And here are today's newlyweds. Couple number one, married 3 months, Vivian and Andy Kendall. Couple number two, married 10 months, Denise and Keith Hyde. Couple number three, married 2 months, Lene and Christian Dangard. And couple number four, married 23 months, Teresa and John Payne. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Newlywed Game, and a real special hello to our four couples. You guys ready to play this game?
Yeah!
You've come to the right place, then. We're really happy to have you here. We're going to start off by asking the gentlemen some questions. And in order to do that, we're going to ask our ladies to head off to our soundproof room. So go, ladies. And while the ladies are leaving, I'd like to remind our husbands that I'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll answer these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. If her answer matches your prediction, you chalk up 5 points. One couple with the most points at the end of the show wins that great second honeymoon. So the ladies are gone, and gentlemen, here's your first question for 5 points. Gentlemen, which part of your wife's body will she say you think bounces the most? Would that be her top part, her middle part, or her bottom part? John, which part bounces the most?
Definitely our top part.
Top She's part.
Well proportioned up there.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Christian.
I am definitely going to have to say the same. My wife definitely bounces upstairs.
Okay, good. Keith.
The top part.
Top yeah. part. Top part.
Yeah.
Andy.
Top part.
That's your top part, too.
Yeah.
Okay, next question, gentlemen. If all of your wife's friends were light bulbs, which one will she say you think was the dimmest? Give me a first name only, please. All of her friends. Christian, which one of her friends is the dimmest if she's a light bulb?
That would be my wife's friend, Julia.
Julia.
Very dim.
Nobody home, huh?
Definitely not.
Nobody home. Keith?
I'd have to say her friend, Lori.
Lori.
Would be the dimmest.
Dim. Yeah. Dim. Andy?
Cindy.
Oh.
Lights are on, no one's home.
No one's home. Yeah. At least she won't be coming to your house anymore. Huh? Cool. John?
Well, I hope she's not going to kill me for this, but her friend Allison, we nicknamed her Nutso.
Go on, figure. Oh, Nutso Allison.
Yeah. Oh, Nutso Allison.
Fine. Here's the last of our five-point questions. Gentlemen, how will your wife say you would complete this sentence? This is you talking. As my wife and I grow older together, we can only hope that she doesn't become blank like her mother. You only hope she doesn't become what like her mother, Keith?
Stubborn like her mother.
Stubborn like her mother.
Yeah.
Oh, stubborn mom, yeah.
Yeah, she's pretty...
Stubborn.
Hard-spoken, yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
She like you?
Oh, yeah.
Not anymore?
Probably not.
No. Yeah. Andy?
Crazy.
Crazy!
I love the woman, but she's crazy.
She's crazier and crazy, yes. John, as she becomes older, we only hope she doesn't become blank like her mother.
Slow. Her mom is so slow to everything. She'll make you late for everything.
Really? Slow, yeah. Christian?
I'm going to have to say, I hope she doesn't become a shopaholic like her mom.
A shopaholic like her mom. All right, gentlemen, thank you very much. We'll be right back to reunite these newlyweds. We'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these. And welcome back, everybody. Gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them flat on your laps each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer. You're going to get 5 points, and I'll remind you all that it's the couple with the most points at the end of the game that wins a great second honeymoon. So we are so glad to have the ladies back, and here's our first question. Ladies, which part of your body does your husband think bounces the most? Would that be your bottom part, your middle part, or your top part? Vivian, which part does he say bounces the most?
Oh, my gosh. Absolutely, definitely my top part.
Top part, definitely.
Yes, definitely. It's, I guess I was kind of blessed there, I think, or he may think that, but I don't think it, but I think
you mean you got a lot of bounce?
Yeah.
All right.
Too much bounce.
Pardon me?
Too much bounce.
Too much bounce. He predicted that the bouncy part of you is your top part. Yeah. Denise, what do you think? Would it be your bottom, middle, or top part?
Definitely my top.
Top part bounces the most.
Oh, definitely. I run a lot, and it bounces all over the place. And he, you know, he's always like, bounce, bounce.
Yeah, okay. He predicted you would say what bounces about you is your top part. Yes.
Yay.
Good. Lene.
I think I'd have to say my top part.
Your top part bounces?
He's always complaining I'm wearing too skimpy of a shirt and that everybody can see my top bouncing.
Oh, he doesn't like you to wear skimpy clothes?
No, definitely not.
Why? They're not on him. What business is it his?
because then he has to, like, fight off all the guys that are looking
at him. Oh, a little jealous that we got going here, right? Oh,
well, definitely.
Yeah. Oh, I see. All right, he predicted that what bounces about you is top card, your top part. Yeah. What do you think, Teresa? Would it be your bottom, your middle, or your top?
I would have to say my top. Because,
your top?
Yeah, because he likes my chest.
He what?
He likes my chest.
Okay.
He does, and it used to be a lot bigger.
Does he like the rest of you?
I hope so.
Well, I do too. John predicted that what bounces about you is your top part. Everybody gets it right. Good. Okay, next question, ladies. Okay. Everybody scores 5 points. Let's see how well you do with this one. If all of your friends were light bulbs, which one did your husband say would be the dimmest? Give me a first name only, please. Denise?
I would have to say Brianna.
Brianna is the dim.
She's really stupid.
Stupid. Yeah. When are you going to see Brianna again? Probably never, yes. Yeah, Keith said the dimmest one would be Lori.
No.
Brianna? We haven't even seen Brianna in a year.
No, but I'm sorry, but Lori, look at where she's going with her life. She is not dumb. Yeah. She's not stupid. She's very bright.
She is.
Yes.
But Brianna.
You're going to be in trouble.
Brianna's a little dim.
Definitely.
Oh, I'm sorry. Lene, who would be the dimmest?
I'd have to say Julia. She's,
really?
She's from Germany, and she's just not all there.
Please don't send the letters to me. Send them to Lene Daggard. All right. No, he said the dimmest one would be a card for me is Julia. Yeah. Okay. What do you think, Teresa, about this one?
I know which one. He calls her Nutso.
He calls her what?
Nutso.
Nutso.
Because she's a little off. Allison?
Who is it?
Allison.
Allison. He predicted you would say it is definitely Allison. Right. What do you think, Vivian?
It definitely has to be Cindy.
Cindy?
Cindy. She's,
why?
She's just a little kind of out there and does things sometimes that are, I don't know, she's just a little, sometimes she does stuff that's inconsiderate, and I think it's Cindy.
Okay, he predicted that you would say that it definitely is Cindy. You got it. Well, we've made a whole lot of friends mad. Let's see what we can do to your mother now here. Last of our 5-point questions. Ladies, how did your husband complete this sentence? This is him talking. As my wife and I grow older together, we can only hope that she doesn't become blank like her mother. Lene.
Fat.
Fat. Christian said, only hope you don't become, card please, a shopaholic like your mother.
I couldn't say fat.
But that's what you went first thought?
Okay. You wanted to, didn't you?
I did, but she's very that's strong.
Yes, I understand. Teresa, we only hope that you don't become blank like your mom.
Oh. I would have to say a little bit overweight.
Overweight. He said overweight, we only hope that you don't become slow.
Your mother's
slow.
Her mom. Your mom is late for everything.
Oh, yeah. She's late.
Vivian, we only hope you don't become blank like your mom.
Crazy.
Crazy.
My mother's crazy.
She's crazy, really?
She's crazy. She's absolutely crazy. And she spends all the time coming over our house. And actually, Andy and her get along really well.
Because
so
he's crazy, too. Is that it?
Yeah.
All right. He predicted you'd say, only hope you don't become crazy like your mom. Well, Denise, what do you think he said?
I'm going to have to say overwhelmed and really busy, just because
overwhelmed
my mom,
and busy. All
yeah.
right. Your husband says he only hopes that you don't become stubborn. Stubborn like your mom.
You're right. Your mom, she's overworked, underpaid, and
oh, don't bail out. You said
yeah, she is.
You said
she
really stubborn is what you said.
But she is.
She's
stubborn
what?
Too.
She's stubborn also.
She's hard. It's not stubborn. She's hard spoken.
No, you said stubborn.
I know what I said.
He's wrong, and I was right there.
Yo, don't back out of that, Anne. We'll be right back to see how well the wives can predict what their husbands will say right after these messages. Welcome back to the Newlywed Game. And now, ladies, your husbands are all secluded off stage. It's your turn to predict what they will say. Remember, each of these questions will now be worth 10 points. Ladies, when thinking about the first time you and your husband were intimate, will he say he was all thumbs, all talk, or all over the place? Lene, was he all thumbs, all talk, or all over the place?
I'd have to say all over the place because we were pretty wasted.
You were wasted?
Yeah. It was Super Bowl Sunday, yeah. And me and my boyfriend who lived down the hall had just broken up. And we were celebrating.
I'm glad you waited a long time to celebrate. Yeah. Okay. Denise?
I would say all talk because...
It was all talk.
Yeah, because we waited a while before we wanted to have sex together.
Yeah.
And he kept saying, are you sure? Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you okay with this? Are you sure?
Oh, Kristen and Lene did the same thing. Yeah. Okay.
So I'd have to say
lock the boyfriend's door and get on with it. Vivian.
Definitely all thumbs. I think he was
all thumbs.
All thumbs.
I'm sorry.
I just think because he was a little bit nervous.
Well,
so,
of course he was
nervous. Yeah, he was nervous.
Yeah, okay.
All thumbs.
Teresa.
I would say all over the place.
He was all over the place.
Yeah, because I made him wait for a year. I made him wait until we got married after a year. We never had an
accord. You made him wait a year after you got married?
No, I made him wait a year.
That's good. Let's not push the envelope here. Okay. Next question. Ladies, where will your husband say was the last place you went together that you had a really lousy time and it was all his fault? Be specific. Last place, Denise, you went together, you had a lousy time, and it was all his fault.
I would say to Mervyn's yesterday.
To Mervyn's, okay.
Because...
Well, you can have a lousy time at Mervyn's, I'll tell you that. Vivian?
We just went to dinner last weekend at, like, a seafood restaurant, and the food was absolutely horrible, but
it was all his fault.
Yeah, he wanted to go there. Well, I kept telling him no.
What was the place? Is the seafood restaurant okay, Judge? Yeah, that's okay. Fine.
Okay.
Teresa?
TGIF's. Restaurant?
TGIF restaurant. Okay,
yes.
That's fine. Lene?
Gosh, I guess I'd have to say our wedding party, because...
Last place you went together, you had a lousy time, was your wedding party.
Because we have an 18-month-old daughter, and I couldn't enjoy myself, because the whole time I was watching after her.
Sure, I understand. Okay, here's the last of our 10-point questions. Ladies, how will your husband say you would complete this sentence? This is you talking. One of these days, I'm going to tell my husband exactly what he can do with his what? Vivian, one of these days, you're going to tell him exactly what he can do with his what?
Oh, my gosh.
Hurry, please.
Exactly what he can do with his... baseball hats. They're
baseball
everywhere.
Hats.
They're everywhere.
Teresa.
With his shoes.
With his shoes.
He has 50 pairs.
50 pairs.
He does.
Lene.
His mother.
It's going to be warm around your house come Christmas. I'll tell you that. Yeah, his mother. Denise.
I would say his baseball hats. He wears them all the time.
His baseball hats. 25-point bonus question. Ladies, which room in your home will your husband say has the most windows? Which room has the most windows? Teresa.
Our living room, dining room.
Now, is that one room? Living room, dining room?
It's one room.
It's one room. Living room, dining room. Okay. Lene?
Living room.
Living room. Denise?
Living room.
Living room. Vivian?
Living room.
Living room also. All right, ladies, thank you very much. We'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game right after these messages. Welcome back to the Newlywed Game. All of our couples have scored some points, so everybody's doing well. And now, gentlemen, let's see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. Remember, these questions will now be worth 10 points. First one. Gentlemen, when thinking about the first time you and your wife were intimate, were you all talk, all thumbs, or all over the place? First time you were intimate, Keith, were you all talk, all thumbs, or all over the place?
All over the place.
All over the place. She said you were definitely all talk, big guy.
That's just all wonderful.
All you kept saying is, are you sure? Because we waited for a long time, so
yeah.
He was all over the place, trust me.
How about now?
I have to, like, pull it out to get it all over the place.
Kristen, were you all talk, all thumbs, or all over the place?
I definitely say I was all over the place.
You're all over the place. She said, yeah, you were all over the place. That's right. John?
I would definitely have to say all over the place.
You were all over the place.
I waited a long time. I had to wait until we were married. Didn't get to test drive. So I was all over the place.
You're not buying a car now. You know what I mean? She said you were all over the place. That's right. Andy.
I'd have to say all over the place.
You're all over the place. Your wife said you were definitely all thumbs.
Are you crazy?
What are you talking about?
You were nervous. Thumbs.
What are you talking about?
You were not all over the place.
No.
He was nervous.
Nervous.
Yes.
Yeah.
Nervous.
What was he nervous about?
Thinking about someone else.
Oh. Okay. Well, try this one out. Gentlemen, where was the last place you went together that your wife had a really lousy time and it was all your fault? Be specific, please, Christian.
I'll say last night when we went bowling.
Went bowling?
Yeah.
Okay, she said the last place you would know, you're going to like this one. It was your wedding party. She had a lousy time and it was
bowling.
Your fault.
We had a good time last night.
What are you saying? You were like all mad at me because I told you to get off my french fries.
What was she doing on your french fries?
Like eating them and I was, get away from my food. And then the whole night it was over. She was
all
angry.
All I have to say is couch.
Well, hey, that's better than, you know, last week I was locked out, so couch is a step up.
Whoa, 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 wait a minute. You were locked out last week?
Yeah, me and my kid. She locked us both out.
Locked you out of where?
Our house.
You locked, she locked you and the baby out of the house?
Yeah, well, for about 20 minutes, but, you know.
Oh.
Well, still was the point. You know.
Yeah.
I had no shirt on.
You didn't have a shirt on?
No. Well, it's a long story.
Your life is a long story, isn't it?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
John.
I have to go with the last time, which would have been La Paz in Baja, California.
All right. She predicted you would say the last time.
We argued a lot there.
You did. She said the last time she had a lousy time when you went to TGIF.
You remember you got it?
That's not the last time, though.
Andy.
I know, I forgot. I'm sorry.
We went to dinner last week at Monterey Bay Canneries and the food was lousy.
All right, she predicted you would say it was at the seafood restaurant. Oh, Judge says, okay, yeah. Keith.
I'd say Laughlin.
Where?
The last time we went to Laughlin.
The Laughlin, Nevada. All right, she predicted you would say it was no at Mervyn's. You had a lousy time. It's your fault, too.
Yesterday, did we not get in a huge argument and I didn't talk to you for half the day because please. You were being
a jerk?
Yeah, okay.
Here's the last of our 10-point questions. Gentlemen, how did your wife complete this sentence? This is her talking. One of these days, I'm going to tell my husband exactly what he can do with his what? John, she's going to tell you exactly what you can do with your what?
Dallas Cowboys.
Dallas Cowboys. And she says she's going to tell you exactly what you can do with your shoes. You got so darn many pair of those things.
He does.
Andy, someday she's going to tell you exactly what you can do with your what?
Sports.
Your sports. She said, no, it would be your baseball hats.
They're everywhere. You have so many stupid baseball hats. They're all over the house.
Keith, she's going to tell you exactly what you can do with your what?
My shoes.
Your shoes. She said, no, it's your baseball hats.
You just complained last night about tripping over my shoes.
Well, she hates your hats.
Did you not say?
Okay, Christian, one of these days she's going to tell you exactly what you can do with your what?
I'm going to have to say my new car.
Your car. Yeah. You know what she said? She's going to tell you what you can do with your mother.
Are you crazy?
Woo! All right, before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon.
You're going to Hawaii. That's right, you'll be staying in a romantic ocean view room at the Kona Surf Resort and Country Club, featuring 36 holes of golf, tennis courts, saltwater and freshwater swimming pools, and complimentary Polynesian shows. The perfect second honeymoon. There you go, Bob.
Thank you, Kramer. All right, gentlemen, here it is, your big 25-point bonus question. Gentlemen, which room in your home has the most windows? Let's go first to couple number two. You have 5 points, Keith and Denise. 25 will give you 30. Get it right, you'll be in first place. Keith.
The family room or living room?
Which one is it?
Well, it's kind of the same. It's only...
She said it would be living room. Yeah, you got it. Couple number three. Christian Lene with 25 would give you 45. Get it right, you'll be in the lead, Christian.
I'd say living room.
Living room. She said it would be the living room. You're right. Couple number four. John and Teresa with 25 gives you 45. John, take over the lead or tie for the lead with the correct answer.
Living room.
Living room. She said it is the living room, dining room. Okay, Judge? Judge says okay. All right, couple number one, Andy and Vivian with 25. 25 will give you 50. Andy, get it right, and you and your wife are going to Hawaii.
Living room.
Living room. You're going to Hawaii. You're right. Andy and Vivian Kendall, you're our Newlywed Game grand prize winners. Hey, well, thanks to all of our couples. Most of all, thanks to you. I had a great time today. Hope you did, too. Until next time, I'm Bob Eubanks. So long, everybody.